The Bathgate Hills, home to many a creature. A place to relax and unwind, but also to explore. Today, I'm following a route that will lead me through some familiar locations, but also take me beyond. Beyond the realms of my current knowledge, into an area that is still mysterious and unknown to me. To the beautiful Lochcote. It all began at the foot of Cockleroy Hill. Crossing the road and into the trees. The forest was still slumbering. Resting. Yet to awaken. The first rays of sunlight beginning to pry their way through the tree trunks. Springtime was here, and the younglings were wobbling around on their new legs. Arriving early at Beecraigs Loch, the air was still, and the water like glass. A very tranquil place. Tranquility doesn't last forever, though. On a small island in the middle of the reservoir, the rising sun hadn't gone unnoticed. There is no path that leads to this island. It's not a place for humankind. For the island belongs to the geese. And they aren't afraid to shout about it. Knowing a losing battle when I see one, I took the long way round, across the dam. Coins littered the spillway, hopefully bringing some luck to those who threw them. I headed back into the forest once more. A labyrinth of forest paths to explore. Emerging from the forest, I headed into the meadows. Finding the sign I was looking for, pointing the way towards the southern boundary path. The edge of Beecraigs. Heading up the slopes of the WitchCraig. The views at the top, spectacular, as always. The Monroe's Ben Vorlich and Stuch Cachron visible in the skyline. and the mysterious waters of Lochcote were visible for the first time. A roe-deer doe snips away at the lush grass, while the stag watches on, wary of my presence. He decides to flee, and she decides to follow. Suspended above, two eyes stare widely at the ground. Remaining silent until it's time to move in for the kill. It was time to move on. Heading down the steep front face of the Witchcraig. A frozen place where the sun had yet to reach. Descending from a hill in Scotland, you might not expect to see a small pagoda standing alone in a clearing. This beautiful building commemorates those who were lost in the Korean War. From here, I headed south along the main road and followed a small country road heading westward towards the small town of Torphichen. A quiet little road, it didn't take me long until I had my fleeting visit of Torphichen. Heading north along another country road towards the legendary Lochcote. Torphichen was now firmly in the distance, but I was starting to question whether I was lost. And why was this no fishing sign out here on the road? An oddly straight line of grass lay ahead, and just behind lay the answers to all my questions. The great expanse of water that is Lochcote Reservoir. ...42 acres of crystal blue water nestled amongst green fields. Tucked away in this lovely little piece of paradise. A very calm and peaceful place. The original Lochcote lay just to the north, but was drained in 1820 to grow crops. All that remains now is this grassy, flattish area. I still had the final leg of my journey ahead, the most unknown part for me. How to get from Lochcote back to Cockleroy. I followed the track onward, past this wee tractor. Through the locked gates and along another track. Passing by some old ruins. Across the open fields that lie under Cockleroy's gaze. I could see the beauty spot was as busy as ever. drawing close, I found a handy sign pointing the way back to the car park. Leaving the open landscape behind, I entered the forest and climbed up through the trees. A few minutes later, and I had returned to where I had started. What a fantastic wee walk. The wildlife, the feelings of remoteness, and the beautiful surroundings. You can't go wrong with a wee walk in the Bathgate Hills. Thanks everybody for watching. Hit subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you all next time.